A lot of my projects revolve around using science and technology as a catalyst for social change. I created a device to detect lead in drinking water, another to diagnose for opiate addiction, and an app to detect and prevent cyberbullying. The motivation for my ideas come from a lot of different places, but I think the biggest motivating factor is the community around me, right? Seeing problems on the news and with people and forming a personal connection with them and wanting to solve it. Being named Time Magazine's first ever Kid of the Year was honestly such a humbling experience for me. I'm so beyond honored to have this opportunity, but I think it's also raised my platform and my voice so that I can solicit new innovators into the wonderful world that STEM is and really show people that, you know, innovation is something that is involved in our daily lives. I heard about the water crisis that happened in Flint, Michigan in the U.S. about 7 to 8 years ago, and I couldn't accept the fact that there was a city in my country where thousands of kids my age were drinking a poison every single day. So I was looking at a way to help detect for lead in drinking water, because I realized that the lack of knowledge of contamination is the bigger problem. So right now I'm working on a way to help detect for parasites in drinking water, especially in third world countries and places like Africa. Along with that, I am working on making the innovation workshops that I run self-sustaining beyond me. In more ways than one, science can be a huge part of human rights.